Howdy Howdy, this is Blue Otter, and today we are playing the 2022 Steam version of the Oregon Trail. Let's start with the prologue. All right, learn the ropes before you assemble the party and hit the trail. Greenhorns, March 6th, 1849. The year is 1849, and a trio of immigrants have become stranded on their way to Independence, the very beginning of the Oregon Trail. David, our wagon is stuck, we're low on supplies, and I think my leg is broken. If we don't get help soon, we're done for. And here comes Stranger. Well, if isn't a party of stranded greenhorns, my name is Moses Harris. Pleasure to be assistance. Now let's take a look at what we're dealing with here. Looks like you got some injuries. Who's in worse shape? Who should Moses Harris help first? Well, David said he had a broken leg, but Julia is highly. So let's examine Julia. I'm a carpenter. I'm usually good at repairing wagons, but my arm is broken. Should Julia be treated with medicine? Sure. Medicine can be used to restore health and help recover from illness or injuries. You're looking better already, Greenhorn. You'd better get that wagon moving again. Could we only help one person? Well, what are you waiting for? It isn't going to fix itself, you know. Amazing, they fixed the wagon and the weather suddenly gets better. It's an improvement. You should really take better care of your wagon in the future. Where are you going anyway? We're going to, right now, to Independence. Ah, yes, Independence, the beginning of the famous Oregon Trail. It's not far from here, and I'm headed that way myself. What do you say you join me? We're saved. Yeah, because you actually got someone that knows what they're doing. Harris joined the party, and we left his horse. Something smells good. Things are looking up. The pleasant scent of frying garlic and onions reaches the party long before the light of the cooking fires. Well, I'll be. If it isn't Moses Harris, still saving travelers on the trail, I see. You look to be in a bad way. I'd be willing to sell you some supplies if you're interested. It's a good deal, just $30. Go ahead, Greenhorns. Saving money is only useful if you live to spend it. Okay. Out of curiosity. And what is this? 1849. Gonna do an inflation calculator here. Okay, so according to the inflation calculator, so that $30 in 1849 would have the same spending power as $1,224.06 today in 2024. In exchange for their money, the woman hands over some toolboxes, clothes, coffee, and a harmonica. I should teach you how to use these supplies. Let's try repairing your wagon first. Toolboxes can be used to repair wagon damage. So open the inventory and access your supplies here. Okay, so we have supplies, toolbox, a box filled with tools necessary for repairing the wagon, sold in sets of three, single use. So we can repair. Okay, so I guess it repairs three sections. Okay. Much better. Now, is there anything else you want to learn about? Let's learn about clothes. Dressing in clean clothes is the best way to combat poor hygiene and protect yourself from disease. So if we do I for inventory, clothes. Sturdy woolen clothes that can be worn by anyone. So we can use... Harris is not my problem. Although, probably need to... Okay. Yeah, joke's on them because I... When I've played this before, it's like... By the time we get to Oregon, you're lucky if you have, like, one set of clothing. There's nothing better than coffee when you're low on stamina. Remember, if you push yourself too hard, you can become exhausted. If we go back to here, we have coffee. We can use that. And it looks like it affects the entire party. Okay, that's good to know. Much better. Now, is there anything else you want to learn about? Let's learn about harmonica. I'm pretty sure this is going to do morale. Yeah. You don't want to lose all hope and become forlorn. Aye. So we can do this. Morale plus two use. Not everyone's low, but we can just kind of do that and top it off. So I can understand where... So there is some complaints about, like, I think that the chief... criticism of this version of the game is that it simplifies things. But based off of this, I can kind of see where it's kind of a stand-in for just about anything. You look much better shape now. Glad I could help. You're welcome to stay a while if you'd like to rest. The woman invites the group to join them for a meal. So sure, let's all sit down. The party, accompanied by other travelers, shares a delicious meal and tales of adventure. The food fills the party with vitality and fortifies them for the journey ahead. So, party health, plus one health, and 5 hours lost. I once fought a beaver for a fish. As the night draws on, the other party retires for the evening, and Harris explains how to survive on the trail. We best set out at first light. I know some spots nearby that are perfect for hunting. Harris shows the greenhorns his map, and together they plan a route for the day ahead. So you can choose which route you want to go to. Hunting grounds, a well-known area for its deer population, a perfect opportunity for hunt for food. What's this one? For its coyote population, a perfect opportunity to hunt for food. We'll do deer. With a plan in place, the party settles in for the night. All right. I did not see the other side because I saw that David still has a broken leg. He should probably... He's got 5 days. Can we don't have any medicine. Okay. Not all wildlife is for hunting. An experienced traveler can recognize all the different animals of the trail. Tap animals to record them in your journal and earn XP. You can also automatically collect animals in the accessibility tab. So if we do... Yeah, I think we might do the automatically collect accessibility just because that could get a little tedious to collect. All right, the party comes across an abandoned wagon accompanied by a lonely ox surrounded by scattered supplies. Looks like something bad happened. You should take what you need to survive, or else you might meet the same fate. You can probably take one of the wheels if you're confident in your carpentry skills. Better to have spare parts in case of accidents. Who should retrieve a spare wagon wheel? Well, I believe Julia was the carpenter. I don't know what Alfred was, and Dave, I just know, has a broken leg. So, Julia's skills as a carpenter helps her retrieve the spare wheel without any difficulty. You'll come across all sorts of situations as you travel. How you choose to deal with them is up to you, but remember that your actions have consequences. Can we collect? We cannot collect the cow. We're just gonna abandon the cow. Well, Harris did leave his horse behind. There are animal tracks on the trail ahead. Stay close and stay quiet. So let's approach with a wagon. Humph. Hunting requires someone who's good at shooting and has plenty of stamina, so make sure you send the right person in. Who will try hunting? Alfred has a 5, so I'm going to assume Alfred. Plus, Alfred isn't injured. Take this old hunting coat and get dressed. Here, I'll even let you borrow my rifle and some ammunition. Harris hands Alfred some bullets. Bullets are required to hunt. It's a little worn out, but you look great. It brings back some fond memories. Remember, you can only carry as much meat as your stamina allows, so hunt only what you need. Yeah, the difference of adult me versus kid me playing. Alright. So move the character and then spacebar to shoot. So we will see. Yeah, this is similar to... This is similar to the original one that I did not have good luck with. Okay. I think that's gonna be enough. So, 50 pounds, really? Ten bullets, minus one stamina. After a successful hunt, Alfred carried 50 pounds of meat back to storage. After hunt, it's always worth taking your time to skin your game properly. Lots of folks will pay top dollar for pelts. The fur trade is a big industry. Take it from me. Pelts can be sold for money or used to protect your wagon when crossing rivers. You've got plenty of meat, so now's a good time to increase your rations. So the size of your party's rations can be changed at any time using the map. So we go to filling. I feel sick. Harris has cholera. He just threw up on the ground. I think I've come down with some kind of illness. I heard there's been an outbreak of cholera recently. I gave you my last bottle of medicine, but I still have some herbal remedy that I made from local plants. So let's come over here. We're going to... Cholera. Okay, treat with herbal remedy. I really ought to see a doctor. We should hurry to Independence as soon as possible. Illness and injuries can be cured by visiting a physician at major settlements. Your party's walking pace can be changed at any time on the map. So yeah, if we're trying to go to grueling, even if we do steady, yeah, even if we change to grueling, it's still gonna be, we're still one day out from Independence. So, one day, 16 meat. Wow, that's a lot. Those got cholera. I can see... I like how they've got some stuff up here, too, that tell you, in short, what you're expecting. I can see definite parallels between this and how the board game... is, because the board game does not have like the minutiae of like an Oregon Trail 2 where you can get down to like getting specific types of meat, specific animals and things like that. Like you can even have like dairy cows and stuff like that and chickens. So but I can understand. Okay, approaching Independence. Here it is, Independence. This is where the Oregon Trail really begins. You can stock up on supplies at Matt's General Store and draft your own party of adventurers at the saloon. You have learned a lot since I met you. Keep your chins up, and I think of the promising future that awaits you when you reach Oregon. I'll see you around Greenhorns. Harris bids the party farewell and disappears into the crowd. And hopefully that might be his horse. I don't know. Thank you, Mr. Harris. Come on, old horse. Oh, good. His horse did follow, because we haven't seen the horse since we came in. Congratulations, your party made it to Independence, the very beginning of the Oregon Trail. Many immigrants like them will brave the trail in the years to come, dreaming of a new life in the Willamette Valley. But how many will succeed? We have guidebook unlocked.